Peace, this is K-Bain, Executive Director of Community Capacity Development.
It's relatively new, so we've been doing this work, as many of us on this call, for decades and generations. We do this work without a paycheck, with a paycheck. This is our investment in our community.
I think everyone on my team is getting, becoming quick experts on Zoom and other technology platforms and media that allow us to do just that social closeness to make sure that we're checking in. I feel like the team that I work with on the ground in terms of the crisis management system has never been this close. So we are here for each other. And I think the magic thing about New York when we deal with community development work is we really put our elected officials in the headlock, like right out the gate. So there's certain things like making sure that the staff is being paid, even working remotely, designing those staff remote work plans, and just making sure people's quality of life, that we're able to maintain it on some level, and doing that by making sure resources and dollars still flow is something that we've been really prioritizing and making sure to keep. And so far, so good. We've been able to do a lot of that. Just needing supplies, resources, gloves, masks, things of that nature, public education material to really engage and connect with the 1 million children that are home from public school right now in the city of New York, whose parents are unemployed at the moment or have been terminated or laid off from jobs. So the last communication I had with NYPD commissioner and some of the deputy inspectors in the local areas and the housing development commanders, as they're called, have been saying, hey, Kay, can you help us to stop people from gathering? Because in the housing developments or projects, as we call them, they're not paying attention to that at all. And we know police contact in our community a lot of the times means arrest and brutality. So they literally have made pleas to us to figure out, can we, prevent that from being the next thing that we see on the news? Police really coming down and physically touching on people. Speaks volumes that we're having these conversations and we're being innovative as we have been, but together. And that unity is so needed and powerful for all to see, funders included.
And we're taking full and total control, and the process is happening now.